Amen. We're glad you're here tonight. We want to welcome everybody to our Christmas program. We want you to make yourself at home and enjoy the service. I want to open us tonight with a couple of verses and then a prayer. And I want to share with you the relevance of what it is we're going to see. Now, some have entered probably through the doors tonight with an expectation that you're going to see the same old thing that you saw before. And I want to share with you something that's a bit more important in its relevance. So maybe as what you do see tonight, it has a meaning to you. It has an eternal significance.
Right.
Not just something that you see or hear. From the 10th chapter of Hebrews, we'll read two verses. As we listen to these two verses, in essence, it is the reason to which the Christ child had to be born. Hebrews chapter 10, verse number 4 said, "For it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away sin. Wherefore, when he comes unto the world, he saith, sacrifice and offering thou wouldest not, but a body hast thou prepared." The reason Christ had to be born was because the blood of bulls and goats would not do. See, our sins required a payment, a blood payment. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sins. And that hasn't changed.
Right. Anybody else?
That is still the requirement.
Yep.
That is still the price for my sin.
Yeah.
But the problem was, is that bulls and goats and turtles and heifers and all of those things that were sacrificed before would not. They could not take away my sin.
Yeah.
Was it possible? And so in Hebrews chapter 10, he explains, number one, that the bulls and the goats are of a different nature. They're not the same thing as a human being. A bull and a goat, it's not the same thing. It's a different nature. And so offering something of a different nature didn't satisfy God's requirement. But number two, they were of a different value.
Right.
I don't have to explain that.
Right.
We eat bulls.
Yeah.
Some of you eat goats, maybe. I don't. But the point is they're not here. The value of an animal is not that of a human being. It could not pay my sin. But lastly, there wasn't one of those bulls, nor one of those goats, nor one of those lambs throughout the history of sacrifice that was ever given.
Right.
And so God sent his son to be born.
Right.
Was it born of man? Mary conceived of the Holy Ghost of God.
Amen.
But Christ was born of man. And because God now had a body, it was that Christ that you'll hear of tonight that lived perfect on this earth and then gave himself at the cross of Calvary for my sin.
Amen.
He paid the price that no one else could pay. We're going to pray now, but let me share this with you. The relevance of what you see tonight is the essence of the salvation gospel itself. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Christ had to be born of the Virgin. He had to be born, not of man, but of God, into this world in order for there to be a sacrifice that could save us.
Yeah. Amen.
And so we worship and we celebrate and we rejoice in this good news. Jesus Christ was born that day in David's city, our Savior. He rose again and can make you his own tonight.
Amen.
You bow your head as we pray. Father, thank you for the privilege of being in this place tonight. And we've come to exalt your blessings. We remember, God, in all of this, that Christ was born. He left his throne in heaven. He came to this earth to be born of man, that we might live through his sinless life. Thank you for this wonderful truth, gospel message of your precious Son. How we pray that by your Spirit you would introduce it into every heart that doesn't know you here tonight. May their hearts be moved and drawn to that place of simple faith in you alone. We love you. We pray for all of these that are part of the plan. Bless them. Help them. In all of this, may Christ be exalted. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Herald angels whom sang for him that day.
R is for rejoicing with the Savior who came our way.
I is for the innkeeper that made a place for him to stay.
S is for the shepherds that came to the manger where Jesus lay.
T is for the travelers, the wise men, that came bearing gifts from far away.
He's our only source of hope, our only living joy, redeeming Lord and Savior for every girl and boy. Long may we serve and trust him, and from him never part. This Christmas may his blessings bring peace to every heart.
Christmas of happiness and love, that sing about the wise men who fall we star above, that sing with happy voices of Christ our Lord and King, born to reward at Christmas of God's great gift, let's sing.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing.
Amen. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, and suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying,
glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace goodwill towards men.
To heaven, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go even into Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had seen they had heard and seen as it was told unto them. Behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Then Herod, when he had privately called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.